The Philippines and Kuwait agreed to resume the deployment of Filipinos to the Middle East nation after a year of suspension. Now, last year, the Philippine Migrant Workers Department had imposed a deferment in the deployment of newly hired Filipino household workers to Kuwait following the gruesome murder of OFW Julibee Danada. The Kuwaiti government, meanwhile, responded by banning the hiring of all Filipino workers. The DMW says both governments have now settled the issue. Among the agreements, installing safeguards for OFWs, including a whitelist and blacklist of recruitment agencies deploying to Kuwait, the electronic payment of salaries to address issues of non-payments, the appointment of welfare officers from both countries, and the creation of a special joint working group that would tackle issues and concerns. The DMW says it is also in talks with Kuwaiti authorities over legal actions on a fire that killed 50 foreign workers, including Filipinos. Now, here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange now in Saipan, Thailand, where he's expected to plead guilty in a U.S. deal that will set him free. Assange agrees to admit he conspired to obtain and publish classified U.S. national defense documents. He spent the last 5 years in a British prison where he was fighting extradition to the U.S. Moving on, 16 Nobel Prize-winning economists signed a letter warning the U.S. and the world economy will suffer if Donald Trump returns to the White House. The letter notes Trump's economic plans would reignite inflation amid his plans to impose stiffer tariffs on Chinese imports. The economists say this will push prices of goods higher in the U.S. On to more news, a U.S. judge rejects a $30 billion preliminary swipe fee settlement between MasterCard and Visa. The two, which is among the world's largest credit card networks, reached their proposed settlement with U.S. merchants in March. Retailers are usually charged as much as 4% of the total customer transaction in swipe fees. The proposed settlement would have lowered those fees by at least 0.04 percentage points for a minimum of 3 years. Meanwhile, Connecticut firefighters sue companies including DuPont and 3M, complaining their protective gear was contaminated by toxic forever chemicals linked to cancer. They say jackets, pants, and other gear leached the chemical into firefighters through their skin, ingestion, and inhalation, and that more of this substance is absorbed as temperatures rise and sweat builds up. DuPont and 3M produce the chemicals used in the protective gear. In other news, U.S. meal delivery group DoorDash reportedly attempted to take over Britain's Deliveroo. Reuters reports DoorDash held talks with a British firm, but the deal failed after disagreement on valuation. A slowdown in demand for online food delivery since the COVID-19 pandemic weighed on Deliveroo's shares since its 2021 IPO. Moving on, German automaker Volkswagen set to invest up to $5 billion in U.S. electric vehicle maker Rivian. The investment will provide Rivian the funding necessary to develop its less expensive and smaller R2 SUVs that are set to roll out in 2026. Analysts and investors, meanwhile, see this as a move for Volkswagen to solve its software struggles. And finally, Nike is set to post its lowest revenue growth in 2 years. At least 7 brokerage houses have cut their price targets on Nike since the start of the month amid growing competition from Deckers, Hoka, and Roger Federer backed On. Nike's fourth quarter revenue is expected to rise only 0.2% to $12.85 billion year on year when it reports on Thursday, June 27. Here's something you may want to check out on your next visit to the Trinoma Activity Center in Quezon City. There, the iconic Amsterdam rainbow dress is on display until today, Wednesday. The dress is a global symbol of the LGBTQIA+ community's rights and resilience, comprised of flags from countries where being part of the community remains unlawful. 8 of those nations can still impose death penalties on those who engage in homosexual acts. The dress was last worn by Filipino queer icon and TV host Vice Ganda. Its artist says he hopes the exhibition will amplify the fight for the Soji Equality Bill.